objected and raised his concerns, but when Uthman ibn Affan understood things differently, he left the matter. He left the matter. And when people asked Ibn Mas'ud, how come you're leaving the issue? Just like that. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud said, Al-Khilafu Shar. He said, Al-Khilaf Shar. Meaning differing. Differing, that is evil, that is mischief, that is bad, that will cause harm. And Abdullah ibn Mas'ud left the issue at that. He still told people, I believe you should pray 2 rak'ah, but he did not pursue it any further. SubhanAllah, what would other human beings do in today's time? Whether Muslims or non-Muslims, what would they do? The shaitan enters and we use that issue, which is a matter of ijtihad, we use it to create divisions amongst the people. Let's remember that we should stay as brothers, even in differences, when the differences are based on ijtihad matters. Some of the other example, another example, SubhanAllah, Muawiyah radiallahu anhu, who I mentioned to you before. Muawiyah was the Khalifa and leader of the Muslims. He was a companion of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Muawiyah radiallahu anhu was the leader of the Muslims from 41 Hijri until 60 Hijri. Almost 20 years, he was the leader of the Muslim, the Khalifa. And as you know, before that, for about 5 years, there were battles between him and Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu. But after that, Ali's son, he did something that no person in history that I know of has done. For the sake of unity of the Muslims, the son of Ali, Hassan, he stepped down, even though he knew he was doing the right thing, but he stepped down in order to make peace between the Muslims, and he gave the leadership to Muawiyah. This was a truly selfless effort from the grandson of the Prophet, Hassan ibn Ali radiallahu anhu. But Muawiyah, when he was fighting before, one of the people who were with Ali, was Abdullah ibn Abbas. Abdullah ibn Abbas was one of the people fighting with Ali radiallahu anhu. But when peace and everything was achieved, later on, some people came to Ibn Abbas. They came to Abdullah ibn Abbas and they said, hey, did you know? They said, do you know? This kind of stuff would stir so much trouble in our generation, Muslims and non-Muslims. They came to Abdullah ibn Abbas and they said, did you know that Muawiyah, the Khalifa, he only believes in praying witr 1 rak'ah. He prays witr just 1 rak'ah. Whereas we all know that the norm and usual to pray witr is 3 rak'ah. 3. So they came and said to Abdullah ibn Abbas, Muawiyah only prays witr just 1 rak'ah. It would have been easy for Ibn Abbas to score a point against his old adversary on the battlefield. But it was not the adversary feelings that came out, but it was the brotherhood of Islam that came forth and shone forth. Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, when people came and said this to him, what did Ibn Abbas say? He said to them to leave Muawiyah radiallahu anhu. He said, innahu faqih. Leave him, why? For verily he's a faqih. He's a scholar. He's knowledgeable. He understands the Islam. So he said, let him be, let him do what he wants, because he's a scholar and he's basing it on the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, and that's his understanding, even though I disagree with that. My dear brothers and sisters, how often we may come across a similar situation where someone might come and say to us that somebody has understood something of Islam in a different way. Now, if it was something that was clearly against a clear, authentic hadith, then we don't just give in like that. But if it was a matter where there is room for differences because it is not so clear, it is easy for us to create differences. As I said, these days people just jump onto these things to score points against one another. Call one another munafiqeen, hypocrites. Call one another even kafirs. And call one another all sorts of names. This, my dear brothers and sisters, is not the way that the giants had behaved in the past. This is not the way that they had behaved in the past. As I keep making the difference, that matters that are clear and open, clear-cut matters, such as someone saying there's another prophet, etc. I mean, that's a clear, big example I'm giving. But those kind of differences are one thing. But these kind of differences, are the other type of differences, the ijtihad matters, are ones where we should still be brothers despite differences. In another last 5 or 6 or 7 minutes, I just want to mention one or two other examples so that they could be inspiring for us as well. Another example, SubhanAllah. Yazid, the son of Muawiyah. We were talking about him just before. Yazid, the son of Muawiyah. When Muawiyah died, he appointed his son to be the leader of the Muslims, the Khalifa. And others did not agree because this was monarchy. This was monarchy and that's not Islamic. But then, other scholars, they, as I said, for the reasons that I mentioned before, they did not fight against that. So when Yazid was the Khalifa of the Muslims, there were some people, there, as far as I know, this person, Abdullah ibn Muti' was not a Sahabi. He was not a Sahabi, but some people prominent in Medina, they were raising allegations against the Khalifa Yazid. Yazid, remember, was living in Syria. He was living in Syria. These people, the rebellion, were in Medina and Iraq. So Abdullah ibn Muti' in Iraq, sorry, in Medina, he was spreading amongst people that the Khalifa Yazid, he drinks alcohol. He drinks alcohol. And Ibn Muti' even said, I saw Yazid drinking alcohol. Or he showed to me that he was drinking alcohol. So this, they came to the son of Ali ibn Abi Talib. Remember again, as I said, the battles between Ali ibn Abi Talib and Muawiyah radiallahu anhu. They came to the son of Ali ibn Abi Talib, the son of Ali ibn Abi Talib, Muhammad al-Hanafiyya. They came to Muhammad al-Hanafiyya, one of the sons of Ali ibn Abi Talib, and they tried to get his support against Yazid, the former adversary of his father. They tried to get his support. What did Muhammad ibn al-Hanafiyya do? Did he just jump on the bandwagon against Yazid because of the old rivalry that was there? No. As I said again, it was the brotherhood of Islam that shone forth. Muhammad ibn Hanafiyya said to Abdullah ibn Muti', he said, I was in Syria myself, and I met Yazid myself, and I stayed there for a number of days in Syria with Yazid. And I never saw Yazid drinking alcohol. I never saw Yazid drinking alcohol. So do you think, what benefit do you think? This is Muhammad ibn Hanafiyya saying to the rebels. He said, what benefit do you think Yazid would have had to hide his alcohol from me and to show it publicly in front of all of you, the rebels? So here, Muhammad ibn Hanafiyya, he defended the Khalifa even though he was a rival of his father. He defended Yazid even though he was a rival of his father, standing for the truth, standing for the unity, even in the absence of the Khalifa. Do you see how, despite the differences, these great giants and the early Muslims, the Sahaba, the companions of the Prophet ﷺ, despite the differences that were there as humans, they still remain brothers and united on Islam. The last example I'll mention before I finish is about Abu Sa'id al-Khudri radiallahu anhu. I'm just mentioning this example after example so we can appreciate that even the Sahaba had big differences, as we saw. But despite the big differences, if it was a matter of ijtihad, that was not clear, then they would not divide up on such matters. They would enjoin good and forbid wrong, but still they would finish by hugging each other. And let's look at the last example before we move on. Abu Sa'id al-Khudri radiallahu anhu, he was a great companion of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. At the Eid prayer, you all know the Eid prayer, normal Friday prayer, you pray the khutbah first, you have the khutbah first, then you have the prayer afterwards. That's the normal Friday prayer. But the Eid prayer is the opposite. Eid prayer is the opposite. You pray the two rak'ah first of the Eid, then the khutbah comes afterwards. The Prophet ﷺ said to the Sahaba, whoever wants to go after can go, and whoever wants to stay for the khutbah can stay. This was the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. After later on when other people were governors, after the death of the Prophet ﷺ, some people didn't want to listen to those governors, they would just get up and walk out. So some of these governors thought, these guys, they don't listen to my khutbah. What I'll do is I'll do the khutbah before the prayer. So they turned the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ upside down. What will we do? We would call those people all sorts of names. Some of us might even be adventurous to call them kafir as well, just because of doing something like that. This is how we might behave. Or we might even say to the governor, you've sold your religion. For the sake of people listening to you, you've turned the khutbah of the Eid prayer upside down. But what did Abu Sa'id al-Khudri radiallahu anhu do? He realized that the governor was doing this because he felt that the main purpose of the khutbah was for the people to appreciate and become better Muslims and listen to the khutbah. And because this is so important and people are going away, he turned the order the other way around for the sake of the people benefiting from it. So he turned the sunnah upside down, yes, But he did it out of some understanding, all that was wrong. But there was a room for difference of understanding. As a result, because there was a room for differences of understanding, and it was a matter of ijtihad, Abu Sa'id al-Khudri radiallahu anhu one day walked hand in hand with the governor of Medina at the time of Muawiyah's Khilafah. The governor was called Marwan ibn Hakam. He walked hand in hand with the governor, Marwan ibn Hakam, to the place of the Eid prayer. Remember, the Eid prayer was being prayed outside the city in order to collect a big crowd. So it's being prayed outside the city to collect a big crowd. So Marwan, the governor, was walking hand in hand with the Sahabi Abu Sa'id al-Khudri radiallahu anhu. Then it is reported in Sahih Bukhari and Sahih Muslim, when they came to the place of the Eid prayer, Marwan ibn Hakam, instead of walking to the place of prayer and praying first, which is the sunnah, he started walking towards the minbar to do the khutbah first, which is the opposite to the sunnah. So Abu Sa'id al-Khudri, with his hand in the hand of Marwan, he pulled the hand of Marwan towards him to take him towards where he should be leading the prayer from, to do the sunnah. And Marwan wrestled, meaning not wrestle, but he pulled his hand back from him. And Abu Sa'id was not happy. When Marwan heard this, when Marwan realized this, he said to him, he said, Ya Abu Sa'id, what you know has now gone. He said, what you know of the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ has now gone. Meaning, he's meaning that with one interpretation, it is gone because the people are going away, so I'm doing the order differently. But of course, he's going against the sunnah. So he said, what you know has now gone. But Abu Sa'id radiallahu anhu, he said, by Allah, there is nothing that you know that is better than what I know, i.e. of the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. So Abu Sa'id raised his objection to the governor about going against the sunnah in a matter of ijtihad. But after that, did Abu Sa'id do what maybe some of us would have done now? Go onto a website, put on a big article against the governor. Or even, if you're adventurous, do an audio CD. If you think you look good, maybe a video DVD. And then you put all of that up there against that person to create divisions amongst the Muslims. But what did Abu Sa'id al-Khudri radiallahu anhu do? He raised his objection, which is enjoining good and forbidding wrong. But because there was room for differences and misunderstanding, it was a matter of ijtihad. As a result, instead of dividing up the Muslims in there in Medina, he simply after that went there, joined the rows, sat down and attended the prayer, even though it was opposite way to the sunnah. Because it was a matter of ijtihad. Do you see, my dear brothers and sisters, this is the beautiful guidance of Islam. And I want